I want to talk a little bit about the tag team division right now. You guys are embroiled in your thing with RK-Bro, Randy and Riddle, potentially going to unify the titles. But talk to me about the tag team divisions as a whole, because you guys have been a constant for, 10 years now in WWE's tag team division. And there's a turnover, but I would make the argument, and Vic and I talk about this a lot, how in the last probably year or so, both Raw and SmackDown's tag team divisions have just blown up. Like, tag team wrestling, particularly in WWE, was never really the focal point. And now it is not uncommon. In fact, it's pretty common to have tag teams open up Raw or open up SmackDown or close the show in the main event. What does it mean to you guys, knowing how much you've contributed, to see how healthy the division is as a whole?
I remember telling Bro when we got on the road, Bro, when we first came up in this business, I remember telling him, man, we are a tag team. Like, we are a tag team. We look like one. We are one. We grew up watching it, man. Our damn family started, like, tag team wrestling.
For sure.
We knew this was our mark, bro. We knew we had to make this a thing. And once we started, like, doing these bangers and tag teaming, every time we went out there and showed out, we putting on for the tag division, like, for all the boys, you know? So every damn week, man, me and Bro, we knew, man, we ain't splitting up. That's why, hey, Vic, like you said earlier, bro, like, we've been together this long because we wanted it like this. You know, we a tag team, bro. This a way of life, bro. We said it in
life, life, bro. That true tag team is a real, it's a real thing. Yeah. Like every saying that we say, who's the one and done, like it's all legit.
We've said it
what
before.
We say, like, in real life.
To me and him, yeah.
Like the we the ones was like, bro, I started like bidding. So I was like, bro, we the ones that do this, we the ones that do that, we the ones that do this. That's it. Who's we the ones.
That's, you know, where that, like, came from.
Because I'm all like, man, we the ones been on this damn house show since we the ones do all these damn interviews. We the ones that do this. We the ones got to go here, then go here. You know, bro, that's it. We the ones, you know, one and done. Seeing tag team wrestling today, man, I'm so proud of it, bro, because you're right. They never put a vocal point on it. And then everybody always talking about, you know, the Hardys and Dudleys and Edge and Chris. Like, yeah, that's cool. Like, I got it now, you know, y'all set the tone, but man, it's the Usos and the New Day now, you know, like we the ones now.
It's very common today as fans and people even within the business, we obviously pay a lot of respect to everybody who came before us, right? We're not here without those that paved the way for us. And it's always, you look back so fondly on, oh man, this guy was the greatest. This guy was the best. It seems to me like it's been a long time. And I could be wrong, but off the top of my head, it's been a long time since there's been anybody in WWE who, in the midst of doing what they do, are talking about being all-time greats. And that's what we have right now with what you guys are doing with Roman. Obviously, the title reign is historic, but to be showing up week after week and saying, hey, enjoy this because I am at that level.
Acknowledge me.
It takes a lot of balls to see that in yourself and to be able to go out there and do it week after week. But not only that, you guys are backing it up. If Roman doesn't do anything else, he's going to go down as, you know, one of the greats from what he's accomplished. And there's still so much work to do for all you guys. There's still so much more to be done. Was that something you guys went, you know what, we're going to talk about this. We are doing some all-time great stuff right now instead of going, oh, well, wait till they appreciate us when we're gone.
Nah, we show up.
We
man.
Really believe this. Was, like we truly, truly believe this. Was, we the ones, right? That every week, bro. We in group texting each other. We know what we're gonna do before we take these flights and go handle even complete the mission. Was, but you're damn right. Our swag is turned up all the way right now, and we're all together. Like, I feed off of him. He feed off Roman. I feed off Roman. The wise man. Like we really own that, bro. When we out there, it's really real. When we step through the curtain, the dogs, pit bulls are running through the neighborhood right now. Everybody better put their babies up because it's about to get real nasty if you still walking out here and don't know what street you on right now.
Yeah, bro, we show up every TV, bro. Right, we show up even the boys. Like,
hey, y'all here, bro?
Yeah,
y'all on my house show? Like,
yeah, bro, we showing up. Like, you can't lie when you showing up every damn week and you out there performing every damn week and you out there working your ass off every damn week. There, you can't take nothing from us. We putting the work in to be where we at today. And I'd be damned if somebody tried to come in here and outwork us, bro, because When I see DeVar, he'd be like, damn, he calls us 24/7, Oos. 24/7, right? You still, we need you down to NXT. I'm like, nah, hold on. You got an Uso down there already, dog.
To that point, I think it was last week or 2 weeks ago, last time you guys were at Raw, we went off the air. I leave the commentary desk, and you guys had just left the ring, and we're just getting back into Gorilla. And I come up behind you, Jimmy, and I tap you on the back, and I said, hey, we're going to need you to do the dark main event. And you didn't even look back at me, and you went, all right, give me a minute. And then you turned around, and I said, I'm messing with you, dude. And we had a good laugh. But that's where your mentality is. You didn't even look back, man, to say, who's telling me this? Hey, we need you to go do another match right now. You went, all right, just give me a second. I'm ready.
For sure.
So 24/7, that's legit, man. That's real.
Like what you hear? Catch full episodes of After the Bell on Spotify. Follow us now and never miss an episode.